phone. Give me that phone. I got that phone. Give me that phone. Give me it. No, it's mine. All right, this video is just going to be a real quick one because it's going to be over 100 degrees today, just like it's been for the last few days. Yesterday it got to 111 here. And it's tough. But under my new awning, it makes it bearable. So we're dealing with the newer, thicker metal. This is 0.030. We're used to cutting and dealing with 024. So this is 0.030. It's a little tougher to work with because it's thicker, but boy, is it solid. I got to tell you, I really like this metal. It's very hard to damage. So here's where we start. Let me get the camera here. I didn't show this because I wasn't going to do this, and I thought about it, maybe I should. But you start from the inside of the trailer and drill a small eighth inch hole right in the corner, all four corners of the window, eighth inch hole. And then you come outside and using that eighth inch hole, using that eighth inch hole, you go ahead and draw lines. These are half inch holes, but bear with me. Using the eighth inch holes, you'll draw lines from one hole to another, which will outline your window. And then you go ahead and put one just above the seam also. And you'll see why in a little bit. After you've made your lines, which I didn't do on this because I'm getting so good at it, I'll make the lines right now. But after you make your lines, then you go ahead and drill a half inch hole above the S-lock on both sides. And you'll see why we're going to need that in a minute. Let me go ahead and draw my lines. I didn't show drilling the eighth inch holes. That should be pretty simple, right in the corners. And I'm going to show drawing the lines right now. I've already drilled the half inch holes. Okay, just imagine these are eighth inch holes. Now we go ahead, draw some lines. I'm using blue ink. Top. You probably can't see now because I don't have it aimed up at the top. I got very close quarters here. It's very hard to get the camera back where you can see what's going on. But let's take a look. Okay, as you can see, got my lines drawn. Pretend those are eighth inch holes. All right. There you go. Once you have drawn your lines, go ahead and position your half inch drill so that the outside is going to touch the lines. Find a place, push in on it so that you get a dimple so that the drill doesn't move around all over the place. Drill your holes. Don't push in too far, you know, because if you do hit wood, you don't want to drill it all out, just in case you miss a little bit. And then drill one above here. Also, just above the S-lock. You'll see why in a bit. And then, of course, the top and the other sides. This is my new tool, Chicago Electric from Harbor Freight. Electric shears, $50. And that's not even on sale. I think I've actually paid $47. Okay, let me make sure that we got the camera showing the right thing here. Okay. Again, this wide format doesn't help because it's not very tall. But watch this. I like this. Now you have to get used to how to hold this thing so it doesn't stop cutting on you. Cut right up the line. Cut right on up the line until you hit the seam, the S-lock, and then go above that. Now you know what this hole's here, and continue. Careful, that stuff is sharp. Did you see that? Just cuts right through. You do that with all four sides, so you didn't see the top. Again, this wide format doesn't allow for that. I'll cut over to the left now and get the holes aligned. There, in the screen there. I'm gonna try and stay out of the way. Maybe I should just go this way. You can go either way. Do that all the way around. We'll go up here now. As far as you can go until you hit the S-lock. Let's see here. One more. See how easy this is becoming? Boy. Okay, now we'll go across the top. I'm gonna go from right to left, so you might not be able to see much, but just know that it's cutting. Getting in the way of my vision. Come on, get out of the way here. Haven't done that yet. Okay, this just pops out. Oops, doggone it. Everything goes wrong when you have the camera on. There we go. Next step. Now you're gonna need, let's see, where's the S-lock? There it is. Now you're gonna need the multi-tool. Like I say, this is really, so far, been the easiest way that I've found to cut out these windows with this thick metal. There you go, window cut out. Now, the only other thing you gotta do is route the edges, which it won't cake up on the router because there's so little metal it has to cut. So I have not had to clean this router for any of these windows so far. Let me get my glasses. All right, so. That's that's it. Windows cut out. That's pretty easy. All right, there we go. I had no idea the camera was zoomed in. I don't know how it did that all this time. Jeez. I didn't really want to do this because it's getting hot and I got to get finished. I have one more window to cut out and I'll show you that one. And it's the same thing. I have the rear window there to cut out. I've already drilled the 1/8 inch holes. It's the same thing but without the seam lock because on the back there is no seam lock. The roof goes all the way over the window. So let me show you that one. I don't know how it got zoomed in. That's the thing with recording. Things happen. And I only have one window left to do. But as you can see, it's already stinking hot. And I'm in the shade. Now I'll go ahead and drill 4 holes. And remember, we don't have an S-lock. And I just position it so it's going to, you have to turn the bit so you can see where the bottom is. Turn the bit so you can see where the side is. It doesn't have to be perfect. Push on it to get a little dimple so it doesn't run around. And make 4 holes. So there we are, we have our 4 holes. Now I'm going to go ahead and make my lines. Now I found that it's best, once you get it in there and cutting, pull back on it a little bit so that it's not riding on the wood inside. The gun moves easier that way. So let's see here. What's the view like? All right, again, when you start your cut, it's best to pull back a little bit on the metal. Keeps the blade away from the wood so it doesn't get hung up. And let's just go ahead and go up first. Follow the line. That one. Missed a little bit, but that's okay because the router will take care of it. Just don't go on the outside of the line. Stay inside. See how nice that works? I love it.
The waste smell is getting in the way. It doesn't do that all the time. This is the only 2 times it's done that now since I started using this thing. I don't know what's up with that, but. Can't see the line.
You always have the problems when the camera's on, don't you? Okay, let's do this last one. There you have it. The window's cut out. So now I'm just going to route the edges and we'll be done. I'm going to shoot some staples in it to get it up close so I don't have to push in too hard on the router. So let's do that. Let's get some staples in it. I use the palm nailer to set these if they don't go in all the way. I see any that are sticking out. Right in there without banging everything up. Okay, that's good. Let me get my glasses. Need a new blade. Bottom was just a little bit low, so don't have to route that. Same with this left side. So it's just the top and maybe a little bit of the right side. Take the window. It's at an angle, it's hard to tell. So there you go. That's how to cut out the windows, or at least how I'm doing it, with this new thick metal. I love this metal, it's so solid. It's hard to hurt, but it's a little tougher to deal with. So, there you go. There's another tip for you from canhamtrailers.com. Don't forget to visit my website. And when you're looking at my videos, please become a member of YouTube so that you can like my videos, so you can subscribe. You'll get notifications when I have a new video out. And go to my website and make a small donation. If you think I've saved you some time and some money, isn't it worth it to you? That's how I buy new cameras, new software, and how I make up for the time I lose doing these videos for you. Today's the last day of this trailer. It's really hot, and I really didn't want to get the camera out, but I went, no, I better show these people how this works with this new metal. So there you go. Have a good one. We'll talk to you later. Happy trailering. This is Mobile Tech signing off till next time. Boy, is it warm.